Hello everyone, this is a video in continuation to the videos which I am making for the different important topics chapter wise. In my previous video, I have discussed the four chapters that are written here, that means cell division, genetics, absorption by roots, transpiration and photosynthesis. Now the chapters which we are going to take up in this video are, I'll be taking three topics in continuation. The first would be population, then we'll discuss something about pollution, and then we'll be discussing about evolution, which is a new chapter which is added in your syllabus. Okay, there were two more chapters, aids to health and why do we fall ill. Those chapters have been removed from your syllabus. Now health organization, sorry. Now starting up with the first chapter, that is population. Now I'll be giving you the different topics. Now listen here please carefully, these topics are for your revision. That means these topics are like, you cannot miss on these topics. There are various random things which are given. You don't have to, you know, it's not like, okay, if you do only these you are sure to get 75. If you have done your revision and you know 100% prepare these, you are sure to get 95% and above. Okay, so starting up with the topics, first topic in population would be causes of a rise in population. It's a general topic, general question which comes. That means what are the different ways in which the population rises, what are the different reasons for the rise in population, what can you do to stop rising of population. So there are multiple, you know, subheadings which are given in your book, like industries, rise in population are due to industries, better medical aids and all. So you have to go through them once. The pointers should be learned properly. Next is how population explosion is a serious problem. This is a separate question. This can also be framed, how can the population be is regarded as a serious problem. Then are the conventional and non-conventional resources. This is a separate topic which is given in your book in this chapter, that has a discussion about fossil fuels, use of solar cookers and all. It's mentioned there. Then is important definitions. This is something very important. These topics can be missed which are given above, but the topics in which they have explained about demography, population density, mortality and natality rate, these definitions are very important. They come as one markers. This chapter plus these three chapters, I can say they are very important chapters for section A, because many questions can be framed from this in the categories which fall under name the following, odd one out category, match the following. So they are very important as compulsory questions. Five marker are less from these chapters, but there can be five markers where they have divided one question into five parts, so they can come as that also, but chances are less. Next is disadvantage of large families. Why there are large families, that means population explosion, which we have done, and a separate topic, disadvantages of large families. What are the disadvantages? Unemployment and all. You cannot feed the children properly. Then are various population control method, the various contraceptive measures. Now for this contraceptive measures, I have made a separate video on contraception. Please go through that video. It's very, very, very helpful. You will not need to look at the book even if you go through that video. The link is given in the description box. Please go to that video and you can see there are different contraceptive, and it's a very important question. This comes in five marker. Tubectomy, vasectomy can come as five marker. The structure is drawn and different questions are asked from it. Then family welfare. The last topic for this chapter is family welfare, which is an organization, red triangle wala, and a question can be framed from that topic also. Then the next topic is pollution. In pollution chapter, the main topics are air pollution, water pollution. So you have to discuss about the reasons for the pollution, what are the different pollutants, how can you prevent pollution, greenhouse effects, biomagnification. These are some topics which are very important from the chapter pollution. Like biomagnification, a separate question from can be from there, greenhouse effect, ozone depletion, why is ozone important. These are some of of the topics which are very important, and general topics related to pollution, different types of pollution, how are they caused, and how can you stop it. It's a very general topic, so the questions which can be framed from it can be general also. Now comes to the last chapter, that is evolution or human evolution, which your book refers. Now this is a new chapter which has been added to your syllabus. Now in this chapter, what I'll say is, as this chapter is a new chapter, there is a question sure shot to come from this chapter. Matlab, you cannot miss on this chapter because it's a new edition, so you have to, you know, go through the chapter properly, because a sure shot one question is going to come from this chapter. Now starting up with evolution, here some topics which are very important, cannot be missed, are the different theories of evolution. Now what is natural selection? Very important. Darwin's theory, Lamarck's theory, evolution also. I have made a separate video which is very much descriptive. There are, I think, 3 different videos for it. Please go through them. You don't need anything else from that, in spite of that. Next is a theory of natural selection. You cannot miss on it. There is a proper definition for it. And then Lamarck's theory of inheritance of acquired characters. There are different, you know, pointers, subheadings under it. These are some of the topics which can be asked as 5 markers that explain the different different characters of Lamarck's theory of inheritance of acquired characters. Explain it and give different examples may use and disuse of organs. Inheritance of acquired characters are there. The questions can be framed from it. Next is the different vestigial organs. What are vestigial organs? Why are they not in use? Why were they earlier present? This is a separate topic, vestigial organs. Please go through that also. Next is what is the Darwin's theory of natural selection? And here they have given examples. Now please listen very carefully. These examples are very important. They can be framed as separate questions also. Like, for example, give the examples which were quoted by Darwin in order to explain the theory of natural selection. It can come under 3 marker or 2 marker, a very important question, which I feel. Okay, the next is this example is very important, the example of peppered moth. It's a very, very, very famous example and a very important example for natural selection. Please do this example thoroughly. It can come, there are chances, 90%, because it's a very important and a very, you know, vibrant question, a question which normally wherever this chapter is there, this question is asked. Okay, so go through this example of peppered moth. Then the difference between Lamarckism and Darwinism. You get a question in section A, that is difference between the following. This can come there also. What is the difference between Lamarck's theory and Darwin's theory? Please do it properly. Then is human evolution. Now what I feel is, there are different, you know, they have given different, you know, erectus is there, Australopithecus is there, Homo habilis is there. So what I feel is, they can give you one organism, and then they'll be asking you the change in characteristics which were seen. Like, for example, Homo erectus mein, what were the features which were seen, which were observed? Then this can be asked like this also, that give the difference between the characters of this and this. This is Australopithecus and Homo erectus. So give the differences between the characters. This can be asked like this. There is one question which can be framed from this topic, that is, what do you think are the changes which occurred from the primitive man to the modern man? Then you have to mention all these are given here in your, you know, when you start the chapter, there are references for the syllabus. Here they have mentioned for the discussion of bipedalism, reduction of size of canine of teeth, development of chin, height and posture, increase in cranial capacity, forehead and eyebrow brow ridges, and a reduction of body hair. This is important because these all point. This can be framed as a question also. Like, for example, give a brief idea of human ancestors with reference to the following characteristics. They can ask you one character, or they can say what were the characters which changed from primitive to the modern man. So this was all about the three chapters which I have taken up in this video: population, pollution, and human evolution. In my next video, I'll be taking up the systems. That means I'll be starting from circulatory system to the reproductive system. And we all know that control and coordination wala chapter mein we have plant hormones, a new addition that will also be discussed in the those videos. I'll be making two separate videos for those. Okay, so please go through the channel, see the playlist, because all these things, whatever I am explaining here, are very well explained on the channel in the chapter. So please do go watch there, watch the video, and then subscribe, like, and comment. Thank you.